This video is brought to you by backblaze.com/minimalistic. More info later. For as long as I can remember, I've tried to improve my desk setup at home in many ways. I had a home studio at my parents' place, then in my university years, I tried to come up with a setup that's easy to move around, but still functional. Fast forward to today, this desk setup is used not only for personal use, but also as my workspace as a full-time back-end developer. Now more than ever, this desk setup has to be functional for my work and video editing use, but also convenient when I want to game a little. In the following, I'll go over the pieces of this desk setup that I changed since I shifted to working remotely all the time. Let's have a look. So one of the major changes I did recently was getting this Amazon Basics monitor arm. As the brand implies, it's fairly basic, no gas spring adjustment, just a simple pole with an arm. The reason why I went with this model is that it has the best cable management I've seen in monitor arms yet. I used to own an Ergotron LX arm and there's no way to completely hide the cables. While with this model, the cables run inside the pole and go out only near the base, at the back, which looks very nice from the front, but even from the sides. Also, I don't think I ever adjusted my monitor after setting it at the right position, so investing in a gas arm seemed like a waste of money, and also a way to add more wobble to my monitor. The pole comes with an arm, but I decided to not use it and mount the monitor directly on the pole so that it wobbles less. I wish it could be adjusted a bit higher, but it's alright as is for now. It's fairly stable with my monitor on it, even though it's quite heavy at like almost 8 kg. I love how it looks, and it gave me back a bit of space on my desk that the original stand was occupying before, and overall, I think it's a really nice and inexpensive addition to my setup. Another way I retrieve additional space on my desk was by adding a vertical stand for my laptop instead of having it resting on my desk. I went with a model made by Satechi as I thought it looked great in black and the width is adjustable, so if I were to replace my laptop, this stand would be compatible with it. By having it behind my monitor, it takes space that I wouldn't really use anyway and it's still quite compact overall. It's still very accessible when I need to, and the ports are easy to reach if I want to plug something directly in my laptop. I also had to buy a longer Thunderbolt 3 cable for this setup to work, as the one included with my monitor was only 45 cm long. So I went with this passive 6 ft Thunderbolt 3 cable. With this longer cable, I can have it coming out of a grommet hole in my desk for a super clean look, and it's always easy to access if I want to plug and unplug my laptop. Now, as for what my laptop connects to, the monitor, it really is the centerpiece of this setup. It's the BenQ PD3220U, and apart from an amazing image quality, this monitor has a built-in KVM switch. That means that it has USB ports to connect peripherals, and host USB ports to connect to two different computers. With the click of a button, not only the video feed changes from one computer output to the other, but the USB ports also switch hosts. This means that I can easily reconnect my peripherals like my keyboard, webcam, and mouse between computers without reconnecting any cable and with a single button. That really helps so much when you have a setup with two computers, as switching between them is a breeze. I also love the fact that it accomplishes that with a single cable to my laptop, providing the video feed, USB connections, and power delivery up to 100 watts with one and only Thunderbolt cable. To extend this useful feature, I added a USB hub in one of the existing grommet holes that came with my desk. That way, this hole can still let cables go through, but it also lets me easily connect USB peripherals. Both standard USB ports are at 3.0 speeds, and there's even a Type-C port and audio connectors, although I don't believe these are super high quality given the price of this hub. Still a very handy accessory that looks nice and is practical, and since it's connected to the monitor, it will be linked to the computer currently in use, which is really nice for me as I review new keyboards almost every week and often need an easy access to both computers' USB ports. I also have this antenna that is plugged in the monitor's USB port at the right, and that's a Bluetooth audio antenna. I could simply use my MacBook's built-in Bluetooth chip to connect my wireless headphones, but using this dedicated antenna has two main benefits. First, it benefits from the KVM, so whenever I switch computers, my headphones are automatically paired with the computer in use, as they stay connected to the same antenna in the end. That's a super handy feature as the old Sony XM2s I use only connect to one device at a time, so switching between devices is tedious. The other benefit is that the range is extended with this antenna. It pretty much covers my whole condo, so it's quite amazing at work, as I can go grab something to eat in the kitchen and still have my music playing with no cuts, or if I'm watching a presentation from a colleague, that's also nice to not miss anything. And then outside of work, it's pretty cool to walk around my unit with music or a YouTube video playing from my computer without worrying about the signal cutting. Honestly, it's one of the accessories I like the most in this dual computer setup. Now, I have a lot of other great accessories to show, but here's a word from this video sponsor, and we'll get back to it right after. Has this ever happened to you? Okay, maybe not, but you've probably lost data in the past. Well, not anymore. Get peace of mind knowing your files are backed up securely in the cloud with Backblaze. For only $6 a month, you get unlimited backups for both Macs and PCs. They have a mobile app to access and download your files on the go, and you can also restore files from anywhere, either directly on the web or even by mail. Upon request, Backblaze will overnight FedEx your data on a physical drive, and you can return it when you're done for a refund. Backblaze currently stores over an exabyte of customer data. Yes, that's 1 billion gigabytes. They have successfully restored over 50 billion files for their customers, and you can be one of them starting today. Get your fully featured 15-day free trial at backblaze.com/minimalistic and start protecting yourself from potential bad times. So back to the accessories I use, I also went ahead and bought a dedicated webcam instead of using the one that's built into my laptop. One reason was to keep my laptop in its vertical stand even during meetings, but it also gives me a better video quality. It's the Logitech StreamCam, and although a bit overhyped as the image quality is not much better than the older C920, I think it looks great in this setup and it definitely does the job fine. Now that I pretty much never see my colleagues in real life, might as well have a better two-dimension version of myself to present. Speaking of lights, I have these three core components for different purposes. So, an Elgato key light on a pole, a BenQ screen bar attached to my monitor, and a bunch of LifeX tiles, bulbs, and strips. The Elgato key light has two main purposes. I use it to light my face during meetings, but it's also one of the main lights I use when I make keyboard review videos. The light quality that's coming out of this panel is great, and I have a second one that's mobile, so I can get a pretty bright scene out of these lights to film my videos. Then I have a BenQ screen bar. I've had this light for a while now, and it's really nice. It takes no space on my desk, but lights up my whole workspace. Look at this. Some will think it causes glare, but because of its angle with the monitor, any glare caused by the light would only be visible from under the monitor and not from a sitting position. The quality of the light it produces is really great, and I often use it to complement my Elgato key lights while filming. Finally, I also use LifeX Z strips, tiles, and a bulb to set the mood. I really like how vibrant they are, and they add color without the need to paint walls nor be stuck with a specific theme. I used to have a desk lamp with another LifeX bulb in it, but decided to move it in the living room instead to reduce the clutter on my desk. Another major upgrade I did was to replace my chair. I went with the Gesture from Steelcase. I had the chance to review the chair like 3 years ago and fell in love with it, and only recently got my hands on a lightly used one. What I like about it is how comfortable it is, but also the extensive armrest adjustments it has. I like how close I can bring them to my body, but also how I can lower them under my desk or set them at the same height as my tabletop. An expensive chair, yes, but I think it looks amazing and it's exactly what I was looking for in an ergonomic chair. I expect to keep it for years to come. I've also had this power bar mounted under my desk for a while and started using it more and more. It's a perfect spot for my camera's battery charger for when I make YouTube videos, but it's also pretty handy to charge my iPad that I got recently and also my wireless headphones. So finally, I recently added acoustic panels on my walls. Their placement isn't final, but it looks something like this. I bought these from Acoustic Panels Canada, and I'm really satisfied with how they look and feel, and it did make a difference in the audio quality of my voice during my video conference calls. I also upgraded to a dedicated microphone, so that's the Rode PodMic paired with the Audient Evo 4 audio interface. I went with the pod mic because it's a dynamic mic, so it doesn't pick up as much of the room sound as a condenser mic would, something like a Blue Yeti. Overall, I'm really satisfied with how the setup looks, but more importantly, how it sounds.
So this is the audio quality you can expect when using your webcam's built-in microphone. Now, this room is completely untreated in terms of like acoustic panels and things like that. So it is kind of a worst case scenario, and the ceilings are fairly high as well. So hopefully after I add acoustic panels and I start using a dedicated microphone, the audio gets better.
Okay, so now this is a sound test with acoustic panels on the walls and a dedicated microphone. As you can probably hear, it makes a substantial difference. My voice is clearer and there's much less echo being picked up. So in conclusion, with all these new additions, my desk setup at home has been the best workspace I've ever had. From my MacBook being connected to everything with a single cable that goes through a grommet on my desk, having access to USB ports that can easily switch between my two computers, having a great video conferencing setup with high quality audio and great lighting, it can't really get better. Well, at least for now. I'll probably make another video like this one next year, and I'll likely manage to find things that I was able to improve. And hopefully you'll be there to see it, so if you stuck till the end, please consider subscribing for more clean desk setup content like this. So that wraps it up for today. As always, I'll have affiliate links to everything you saw in this video in the description. Feel free to use them if you're interested and want to support the channel at the same time. Again, thanks to Backblaze for sponsoring this video. Visit backblaze.com/minimalistic so they know you came from here. So thanks for watching. Make sure you leave a like if you did, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, as I'll see you in a future video.